deep spirituality needed today. Surely there is something within each of us that craves to be more spiritual. We desire to be wholly dedicated to the Lord for His service, and we must be. We need to be so close to God and so full of His blessings and power that He will be first in our lives every moment. Surely there is a place that we can reach in spirituality that we will be involved with the blessings of God to the extent that we will be fully able to accomplish the purpose for which our Lord has called us. And we can find this place if we will humble ourselves before God and seek His face and yield ourselves to Him until He rules supremely in us. We need an abundance of overflowing spirituality, that everything we will do will prosper and everyone and with whom we come into contact will be blessed. There is no doubt that many today are just wandering around in spiritually ankle deep, as Ezekiel did in the river when he had the vision of the holy waters. But that condition did not seem to last long with him. When he was brought through the waters, the second time they were to the knees. Then, when he was brought through the third time, the waters were to his loins. The river was getting deeper all the time, and when it was measured again, he could not wait any longer. There were waters to swim in, and the trees that grew on the banks, they flourished and produced food, and there were plenty of fish in it. This river that Ezekiel saw had healing properties, and everything that its waters touched was fruitful. What will deep spirituality produce? Well, look at the water that is ankle deep. Is it not of much use only to play around in a little? The same is true with waters that are knee deep. And when it is deep enough to come to the loins, children could have a good time in it, but a grown person would want deeper water. But when it is deep for good swimming and for fishing and for watering the valley in which it flows, then it is worth something. This same concept can also be used when speaking about deep spirituality. When one is spiritual enough so that he can bear an abundance of fruit, he will be a blessing. His love for the lost will cause him to seek to win them for God. His interest in God's cause will stir him continually until he can't rest unless he is doing something for the advancement of the Church of God. His zeal will be continuous. It will not be high today and low tomorrow. God can use him, and he will be able to accomplish something. And God can depend upon him. He will not be here today and gone tomorrow, but he will be found on the job all the time. Does it pay to be deeply spiritual? Well, I have touched a little on what it will cause people to do in the service of the Lord. But this is not all. We sing about peace like a river. And when one is deeply spiritual, he will have that overflowing peace that passes understanding. Oh, he can swim around in it and enjoy himself to the fullest. And he will have the presence of the Lord with him in a very real way. The sweet, sweet peace of God. That feeling deep down inside that comes from having the Lord near to bless. That encouragement and that help that can only come from him. You know, James said, "Draw nigh to God, and he will draw nigh to you." I believe one who is deeply spiritual will practice drawing nigh to God until he will just do it without thinking. And any time we make an effort to draw nigh to God, we have the blessed assurance that he will come close to us. One who is deeply spiritual can be assured of the guiding hand of the Holy Ghost operating in his life, and he will be able to say to the Father at all times, "Not what I will, but what thou will," because he will seek the will of God in preference of his own will. Many people have to have their own way, but not one who is deeply spiritual. He can yield his own way and submit with a smile. A deeply spiritual person will manifest love. To begin, he will love God who is love. Then he will obey the words of Jesus when he said, "A new commandment I give unto you, that ye love one another as I have loved you, that ye also love one another." Peter adds a little weight to this when he said, "Seeing ye have purified your souls in obeying the truth through the Spirit unto unfinished love of the brethren, see that ye love one another with a pure heart fervently." Fervent suggests great warmth and earnestness of feeling. So when one loves fervently, he will show it. It cannot be hid. Peter uses this word again in connection with love when he said, And above all things, have fervent charity among yourselves, for charity shall cover a multitude of sins. Since he introduced this thought with the words, and above all things, we can feel that it is very, very important for us to have this fervent love among us. Now, if we are deeply spiritual, our love will not be confined to our own people, but it will reach out to the lost. We will be possessed with a portion of the great love our Father in heaven hath for the lost, when he gave his only begotten Son that they might be saved. It would also reach out to the poor. And we know that they are loved of God because the wise man said that when we minister to the poor, we lend to the Lord. And then our love will extend to the sick, the unfortunate, the troubled, the discouraged, and any others who may need a little love. We have sung the song about the world dying for a little love, and we believe this is true. So we need to have this love that will reach to every creature. James said, "If ye fulfill the royal law according to the scripture, thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself, ye do well." Jesus made it clear with our neighbors that we are to love them. And he called this commandment the second, and it was like unto the first, which is, thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, and with all thy soul, and with all thy mind. The deeply spiritual person will order his conversation aright. His mind will be on the good things, and he will talk about them. He will not criticize or speak harshly. He will not take up a reproach against anyone. He will follow the advice of Paul to Timothy in being an example in conversation, and to Titus in being a pattern of good works, which includes sound speech that cannot be condemned. Deep spirituality is in the heart, but it will certainly manifest itself on the outside. It will make itself known in our appearance. It will show in our word and in our deeds, and it will manifest itself in our attitude towards others. He that lives in this will not seek to elevate himself or work for his own interests, but he will seek to help others and build the work of the Lord. He will not have respect of persons. God is no respecter of persons, and the deeply spiritual man will not be either. And according to Brother James, it is a serious offense to show more respect for one than for another. He said, "For if there come unto your assembly a man with a gold ring in goodly apparel, and there come in also a poor man in vile raiment, and ye have respect to him that weareth the gay clothing, and say unto him, sit thou here in a good place, and say to the poor, stand thou there, or sit here under my footstool. Are ye not then partial in yourselves, and are become judges of evil thoughts? But if ye have respect to persons, ye commit sin, and are convinced of the law as transgressors." Now, isn't this enough to cause us to want to steer clear of having respect of persons? Surely it is. But in this, I want to encourage you to continue to seek the Lord for a deeper spiritual life. I believe all of us can remember that it is said of those who are lukewarm, "I will spew thee out of my mouth." Let's move up closer to God and have his blessings upon us in the measure that is needed. It is through the Spirit and the power of God that our work is accomplished, and without his help, we can do nothing. And the more spiritual we are, the more God will bless us and use us for the upbuilding of his cause and for his glory. We shouldn't have a service that does not bless the people. It is not all shouting. But where people are deeply spiritual, there will be some shouting because they have something to shout about. Everyone should be able to say at the close of every service, as Peter did on the Mount of Transfiguration, "It is good for us to be here." Because of what? Because of the presence of God and because of the manifestations of the Holy Ghost. Our worship should be sincere and our fellowship should be sweet. And when we are blessed, others will become interested in due time, and they will be blessed also. In spiritual services, we can expect lost souls to be convicted of sin, so they will seek the Lord and be saved. And what will bring greater blessings to our hearts than seeing souls that are lost pray through and rise from their knees with their faces shining with the glory of God and their voices lifted in shouting the praises of God? And our souls are blessed when believers are sanctified and baptized with the Holy Ghost, Many times we also feel like we receive these experiences all over again when we pray for others and see them blessed. The business of the Church of God of the Bible must be carried on, and the more spiritual we are, the better we can do business for God. But if we are allowing the business part to crowd out the spiritual, then there is something wrong, and we should find out where we are failing and make the necessary changes. Everything connected with the work of the Church of God is important. So the financial part, yes, it's important, but we can't carry on the work without finances. But we can't afford to press this part of it so much that our services will become formal. Without the Spirit of God and the manifestations of the Holy Ghost, we are nothing. So let's yield ourselves to God and for His service, and let Him have His way with us in all that we undertake to do. It is needful that we be deeply spiritual. So let us strive to become more spiritual and be a greater blessing than ever before to one another and to others. Let us be spiritually minded, because this life and peace that we have today can only come from God. Let us admonish one another in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs. Let us draw close to God and one another, that we will have the same love and care for everyone while we are doing God's work. There is a place in the Church of God for everyone. All are needful. All are wanted. The old are needed, the same as the young. Their wisdom gained through years of experience is a great asset to the church. They possess this that the younger member does not have now. However, the young has more strength and energy than the older. So we need both young and old, as well as the middle-aged. The uneducated are needed the same as the educated. All have a work to do and a place to fill, and one cannot take the other's place. And none should have the preeminence, because God does not look upon one above the other. The poor are needed the same as those who are not so poor. Jesus gave special attention to the poor when He was on earth, and He loves them now. Even the very rich are needed, if they will give their hearts to God. The plan is for all to be one. So let us all together stir ourselves to deeper spirituality and go forward to do the work marked out for these last days. God bless you.